Saturday morning in the Sig Biker studio. Today we talk about MTB and road-specific clipless pedals because yes, there are some myths around this topic and I'm going to share with you three most common in my opinion. And later on today, my last race from last Saturday, and tomorrow I'm racing again, which is so exciting. But let's move on to our topic. Short info for the beginners, this is the clipless pedals for the mountain bike and this is a special shoe with the cleat that will fit this pedal. Clipless pedals allow us to clip into the pedal just like that and have great connection between our shoe and the pedal, and then we can unclip like that. And this is the road bike specific system. It basically works in the same manner, allowing us clipping in and clipping out from the pedals, but has a different design. It's time for the first myth, and it's a huge one. People who buy their first SPD pedals or clipless pedals, they discover, wow, now I'm just like one unit with my bike and so I can jump. They mean they can go over obstacles up to 10 or maybe 20 centimeters high. So their conclusion would be, if you wanna improve your technical skills, especially jumping or bunny hopping, buy yourself a clipless pedals. Wrong. This is so wrong. The clipless pedals won't improve your technical skills, especially in terms of the jumping, because what you're gonna do with the clipless pedals, you're gonna just pull your pedals with the cleats that you have attached to your shoes. That means you're not learning how to use the weight of your bike. You're not learning how to grab the pedals. You're not learning how to preload when you wanna learn bunny hopping. So clipless pedals, they are very helpful in the terrain, and I use those for cross-country mountain biking. It's really the best idea, but if you really want to learn the basics of technical skills, get yourselves a platform pedals. You're gonna have to learn much more and feel much more in terms of the weight of your bike and how to handle it comparing to the clipless pedals. So clipless pedals, yes, they help, but also notice that many guys who ride in super demanding technically terrain would quite often go for the flat or platform pedals. Here is the myth number two, and it's once more linked to those who buy these pedals for the first time, and they will discover, wow, now I can pull the pedals up, which is certainly not possible on the platforms, on the flat pedals. Even if you have these small cages, the old school fashion, old fashioned cages, pulling is not really the option. The SPD pedals will help you with that, but they are not made for it because there is no such thing as round pedaling. You can just go back to my episode about pedaling technique. Yes, the clipless pedals allow us for pulling, and we do pull when we, for example, sprint or in some technical terrain, we need to use some higher gear and a lot of power, then we push with one leg and pull with the other, but that would be on extremely low cadence. In most of the cases, when cadence is 70, 80, 90, 100, we do not really pull here from the bottom of the pedal stroke, because just lifting the weight of our feet is sometimes impossible at cadence of 80, 90, 100 and more. So these pedals are not made for round pedaling because there is no such thing as round pedaling. High cadence, yes, they help. Difficult terrain, sprinting, then we can pull, that's true. But round pedaling and pulling your pedals always from the bottom of the pedal stroke is just a myth. And the third myth about clipless pedals. These are extremely dangerous when we crash. And that's a myth, because these have pretty smart design. You'll be able to unclip moving your heel outwards or inwards as well. So both ways, that's one thing. Another thing is that we do have the adjustment on those springs, on most of the designs of the pedals, so that clipping in and clipping out, especially for those inexperienced riders, can be easier. And also there are different designs of the cleats that sometimes help just in emergency situations. But in general, if you crash, you don't even think about unclipping. It just happens. It is so natural and subconscious, I would say. This is, I mean, you do not have to worry about that. Yes, when you buy pedals and when you learn to do a switchback, for example, it may be a bit tricky at the beginning, so just make sure you have some basic skills if you go for some technical terrain. But for those who use clipless pedals for, let's say, 2 weeks or 3 weeks, it happens just naturally and you don't have to worry about it. And finally, the road clipless pedals. Since I said that we don't really pull up with our feet and there is no such thing as round pedaling, why do we actually use, and these are so popular, the clipless pedals on the road bikes? Well, on the road bikes, these are extremely helpful because on the road bike, that's where we get the highest RPMs, so our cadence. We do spin quite quick and fast on the road bikes, 90 RPMs, 100, 110, and even more when we attack, for example, and we really want to push a lot of power, then the clipless pedal will really stabilize our feet on the pedal. So we do not have to use any other muscles in order to just keep in touch with our pedals, because clipless pedals do the job. So these are extremely helpful for higher cadence. And just to give you an idea of how it actually works, when it's helpful, when it's not, road bikes always, mountain bikes, it's the very demanding terrain in the gravity MTB, where some riders would even choose the platform flat pedals over clipless pedals. So let me know, what do you think about it? Which are the myths that you've heard about, or something that has changed your life when you bought clipless pedals? Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna see you soon. Bye bye.